Hello developers, welcome back. Here you can see when we add product to the cart, it is immediately listed into this mini cart. But here we are not getting any feedback that this product is added into the cart. So today in this lesson we will create a notification component that will display notification messages like product is added to the cart or product is removed from the cart. And we will display that notification message right here at this corner. So before moving ahead, a quick reminder, if you are new to this channel, hit the red subscribe button and press bell icon so when I upload new videos you get notified. Now let's start. Here in the components directory I'll create notifications list.view. At the same time we may have more than one notification, so this notifications list component will contain all the notifications. And we will create another component, notification message.view, and this will render the single notification message. Now in the notifications list component, here the component boilerplate. Now here I'll create div and let's say it's class notifications list. Now I'll create a style for that. Position fixed, bottom 0, right 0, and margin right let's say 15 pixels, and finally width let's say 320 pixels. Next, this component has list of messages, so here we'll import notification message component, and here I'll add components, add this right here. Next here I'll add notification message component. Now in the notification message component, let's add view boilerplate. Now here I'll add bootstrap 4 alert HTML markup, and now let's add this component in the root app.view component right here. So first here we'll import components notifications list, and we will add that in the components list. Next, right here add notifications list. Now let's see this in the browser how it looks. Right here we got the layout. Now if we have more than one notification message, it will look like this. Now let's implement this in the Vuex store. So here we have modules. For this notification message, I'll generally like to create a new notification module. But here the base actions, state and mutations are empty. So I'll add this in the base level because for the sake of tutorial, I want to add examples, modules and base, state, action, getters, mutations. So in the store state.js, here I'll add notifications and it is initially empty array. Now in the store actions.js, here I'll say export const add notification is equal to, here we have commit and notification. Now in this section I'll commit a mutation, that is push notification, and here we pass notification. Now we need to create this mutation. So in the mutations.js, here we'll say export const push notification, and here we have state notification that we want to push, and then here we'll say state dot notifications dot push. Now we want to push an object, and using object destruct we'll pass notification, and then we want a unique ID. Now this notification will contain an object like this, has a type is like success or error, and then we have notification message. Now in this notification, we are missing ID. So here using this way, it will add ID right here. So now here generate a unique ID. Let's see this in browser how we will generate an ID. So in the inspect tool, console, let me zoom little bit. Now to generate unique ID, here I'll say math.random to generate some random number, and then I'll convert that into base 36. It will generate these alphanumeric letters, and then I will add date.now, and I'll also convert this into base 36 like this. Now this will work, but in case if you want to remove this 0 and dot, then here we can add, first let's enclose this in the parentheses, and then we can add substring, and we pass here to remove first two letters. Now we have this unique alphanumeric letters. Now let's copy this and I'll paste that right here. Now in the notifications list component, here we will get this notifications state. So here I'll add import from Vuex, and here I'll want to import map state. Next here I'll add computed property, and here I'll add map state, and here we'll get this notification state. So I'll pass that in array like this. Now here we can say v-4 notification in notifications, and I'll bind key notification.id, and next I'll pass prop notification is equal to notification. Now what we are doing here, we added the for loop notification in the notifications state, and here we bind the key notification.id, and we pass that notification as probe. Now in the notification message component, it going to accept props notification, and next here we will say notification dot message. Now here I want to add class according to the type, like if message type is success, then here I'll add class alert success, or if message type is error warning, accordingly I'll add classes here. So for that, here I'll create computer property type class, and it will return, I'll add a template literate, and here I'll add alert hyphen this dot notification dot type. Now here we can bind class type class, and I will remove that class from here. Our next step is to add notification messages on add product or remove product. So let's first close all of these. Next in the modules cart actions.js, right here we are adding product to the cart. So here we will dispatch action add product to cart from store action.js, this one. So here we'll pass dispatch, and then we'll say dispatch action name, that is add notification, and then we pass the payload data. Here we pass type is success and message product added to cart is done. Still it will not work, because inside the module when we try to dispatch an action, it is trying to find this add notification from the cart modules, like this cart and then module, but actually this add notification is not in the, it is in the base action. Let's see this. Refresh. Now here if we try to add to the cart, you can see unknown local action type add notification, global type is cart add notification. So to fix this, here we will pass a third argument, that is root true. Now this time, if we try, it worked. Now let's close this, add more products, and we get the notification like this. And from here we can close this. So it should close automatically after 3 or 5 seconds. So first we will add a remove notification action. So here we'll say export const remove notification, and it'll pass commit and then notification. And here it will commit remove notification. It'll pass the notification payload data. Now we'll create this mutation. So in the store mutation.js, it'll say export const remove notification, and here we have state notification to remove, and next here we'll say state dot notifications is equal to state dot notifications dot filter notification, and here we'll say return notification dot id not equal to notification to remove dot id. Now here what we are doing, filter the notifications and return all notifications where this notification id is not equal to the notification to remove id. Now in the notification message component, here I'll import from Vuex map actions, and here I'll add methods map actions, and I want to fetch this remove notification action. So now I want to close this message after 3 seconds. So in the created method, here we'll say set timeout, and here I'll pass timeout 3000 for 3 seconds, and here we'll say this dot and then this remove notification action like this. Now here it will work. It will automatically close this notification message component after 3 seconds. In case if we add any logic to close this component manually, in that case this component could be closed while this set timeout is still running, potentially create a memory leak, and that is not good and we don't want this. So to avoid this, here I'll add data and it will return timeout, and initially it is null, and next here we say this dot timeout is equal to set timeout this function, and next here we'll add a lifecycle hook before destroy. Here we'll say clear timeout this dot timeout. So here what we are doing, we initially initialize a timeout data which is null, and then we store the set timeout in this timeout variable. And then before destroying, we clear the timeout to be safe. Now let's see this if it works. Refresh and we add product to the cart. Displayed flash message, and after 3 seconds, it should disappear. It did not work. Let's see what is the error. Cannot read property ID undefined. Actually, error is here. We forget to pass this dot notification. Now refresh again, and this time it should work. 1, 2, 3, and it disappeared. Add more, and should disappear automatically. Similarly, we will add this on remote product. So in the store modules actions.js, we'll copy this and add that right here, remove product from the cart. And here it will accept dispatch. And here we'll change the message, product removed from cart. Similarly, I'll add that here also when we are clear the all cart items, here it will accept dispatch. And here we'll say all products removed from the cart. Now let's see this, refresh, we add product to the cart, working, and we remove product to the cart, here we get the message remove product from the cart. Similarly, clear cart, and here we get all products removed from the cart. All is working. This is all in this video, and thanks for watching. If you like the tutorial, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.